Oh, that was nothing. You should try a kayak in the Okavango swamps.
Yes, I read your book, A Bloke in a Boat in Botswana.
Oh, thanks, Harry. I'd heard I'd sold a copy somewhere.
Travel books are my passion, a distraction from the daily rigors of the London rush hour.
Do you two want to hear something interesting? You see this taverna?
I'm rather impressed. I remember there being an old hut here. I was dreading bedding down with the goats.
Well, give me goats before camels. There was this one time in the Kalahari. The sun was beating down.
Sorry I didn't interrupt you there, Indiana. But the point is, this is my taverna. I built it. Well, I designed it. Drew up the plans, what, 21 years ago? Can't believe she's gonna build the damn thing.
Who?
Well, Donna, who else? This is something I scribbled on the back of a menu. I had no idea.
Well, how do you know it's yours?
Oh, buildings are like babies. You always know your own.
Oh, well, I wouldn't know anything about babies. I've been living out of a backpack all my life.
The happy wanderer, eh? Do you think the island will inspire some prose?
Well, I hope so. When I left, I sold my editor a piece on childhood hunts revisited.
Were you born here?
No, I was born in the U.S., but my mother's Greek. Nah, the only time I came here was to visit with my great aunt on the mainland. That was about 21 years ago.
So now you can write about Sam's taverna, and the tourists will flock.
Nah, I think this island should remain the secret idol I've always remembered.
Yes, but perhaps if you lived here, the idol would be the boatloads of tourists with big bucks.
At least they might have some staff then. Where is everybody?
Good afternoon. Can I help you?
Hi, I'm Bill Austin. You have a room for me?
Bill Austin?
I'm Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry? So you must be...
Sam Carmichael. You are expecting us?
Yes, I'll go check on your rooms.
Charming. I do hope to get my tongue around a little Greek. I haven't spoken it in 21 years.
21 years, huh? You know, this is beginning to sound a bit like a setup. Hey, Bill, there's a story for you. Three men, strangers, receive an invitation to a wedding. They're invited to a place they haven't seen in 21 years by a woman they haven't seen in 21 years. Why are they here?
All right, Sam, that's not bad. Okay, Harry, still, what's drawing you away from the Bank of England?
Is this an interview? All right, well, for me, Donna's invitation brought back many happy memories. Bloody Nora!
Is that a quote?
No, no, I know this guitar. HB, headbanger, and that's what they used to call me in those days. And DS, Donna Sheridan. I bought this guitar for her. 10 quid and my Johnny Rotten t-shirt. So now who says I'm an unadventurous old stick in the mud?
Who?
My other half. A big house, fast car, and a season ticket to the Chelsea Football Club isn't enough for some people, is it? They want the great white hunter, too. Well, I can do spontaneity. That's why I'm here. Donna knew my wild side. I was an exchange student in Paris when we met, and I just followed her to Greece spontaneously. Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. We used to sing this one. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
You're Donna's daughter.
Yes.
I look familiar. Sophie.
It's just Sophie.
No, Sophia's the Greek. I had a great aunt, Sophia.
I'm named after a Sophia.
Where's Donna? I'd love to see her. Thank her for the invitations.
Yes, it's very kind of her to remember us.
Oh, you can't. You're secretive. I sent the invitations. Mom sent them.
But why?
Oh, Mom's always talking about her friends from the old days, and I thought she'd be thrilled if I invited you here. But she's got herself in such a state over this wedding, mentioned unexpected guests, and she'll hyperventilate.
Oh, Sophie, hang on. Are you telling me Donna didn't invite me?
No, she didn't. So, pretend you're here for a holiday. She'll see you at my wedding, and we can let her in on the secret.
Sophie.
Mother says I was a dancer before I could walk.
Wait, you made a mistake.
She says I began to sing long before I could talk. And I've often wondered, how did it all start?
Songs I'm singing, thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
Sophie, I really don't mean to spoil your lovely surprise, but the last time I saw your mother, she told me she never wanted to see me again. So if you're the one who sent the invitations, I'm so bad.
But that was years ago. I went in here.
Why?
Because it's my wedding, and I want us all to be friends.
You're just a little minx. You're worse than your mother. I'm glad you haven't met my boys.
Your boys? You have sons?
Yeah, I've got two. God, I'd love to bring him here someday.
Like you used to bring my mother?